So I want to take a little time today to present to you the idea of sample space diagrams. All right? Now, let me give you a situation why we want to use this. Right? We talked about in class the situation where we have two dice, right? We're going to roll the two dice. We want to know the outcomes, the probabilities, things like that, right? Well, we talked about in class that we could use a tree diagram, right? We could say, well, on die one, I could get a 1 or a 2 or a 3 or a 4 or a 5 or a 6. And then after that, die 2, if die 1 is a 1, the outcomes for die 2 are that die 1 could be a 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6, right? And then if die 1 is a 2, die 2 could also be a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I think you could see how very quickly this could become very messy, right? So what we want to do is we want to come up with a different way to be able to present this data when I have two things happening, either two individual items or two events that one happens and then the other happens. Independent, dependent, doesn't matter, okay? But I want to be able to have two different ways of presenting this information, all right? So instead of a tree diagram, we're going to use what we call a sample space diagram, or a 2D grid diagram. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to create a two-dimensional grid. On the left-hand side, we're going to write everything for die 1. So die 1 could be a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, or a 6. Die 2 could also be a 1, or a 2, or a 3, or a 4, or a 5, or a 6. Okay? Now at this point, you just create a line, just like I did for number one there. Create a line for each of those numbers. Okay, so 4, 5, 6, and then for 1 on die 1 as well. So right there, right there. Okay, so now what you're seeing, this is why this is often called a 2D grid, but what you're seeing is a sample space diagram for the two dice. Anywhere where the two lines cross, you get a different possibility, right? This is 1, 1. This is a 2 on die 1 and a 1 on die 2. This one right here is a 2 on die 2 and a 1 on die 1. And so you can see that each of these points represents a different combination of rolls, okay? Now, what that means is that we can count up the total number of points. Now, you don't actually have to count them up, right? Because we know that if there are 6 here and 6 there, that there are a total of 36 possibilities. Okay? Now what this does is it now allows us to answer the same types of questions that we were answering before. Okay? So for example, if I wanted to answer what is the probability that it is even? Okay, well, probability that it's even, I'm going to count up that the sum is even. Well, how do I get an even sum? Well, I either add two even numbers together or I add two odd numbers together. So, odd numbers, that would be this one right here, or 1 plus 3, or 1 plus 5, right? Those would all give me an even sum. Right here, 2 plus 2 would give me 4, 2 plus 4 would be 6, 2 plus 6 would give me 8, so those are all even, right? I can go on and I can look at 3, so 3 plus 1, and you should notice that there's kind of a pattern going on, right? And by recognizing all of the places where we get an even sum, adding odds, adding evens, we note that in the end we have 18 different ways to get an even sum, out of 36, which of course is 50%, or one half probability. Okay? We can answer other questions. How about, what is the probability that die 1 is less than die 2? Can we answer that question? Of course. We can find the points on the graph. I'm going to use a blue marker this time to help us differentiate. So I want to find the places where die 1 is less than die 2. So here they're both 1. Here, die 1 is 1, die 2 is 2. So right there, die 1 is less than die 2. Okay? For all of these, points, right? For all of these, die 2 is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Die 1 is 1. Okay? Look at the next row. If die 1 is 2, then it will be less than die 2 when die 2 is 3, 4, 5, or 6. When die 1 is 3, then die 2 can be 4, 5, or 6. Again, you're probably starting to see a pattern. Okay? And there we go. Now you count up the dots. 5 plus 4 is 9, plus 3 is 12, plus 2 is 14, plus 1 is 15. So therefore, 15 out of 36, or 5 out of 12. All right? So you can kind of see how this might be helpful in organizing something where you have two different things. Now, this only works if there are either two situations, like I roll a die and then flip a coin, or if there are two individual objects that are being done at the same time. Okay? If there are three situations, you roll the die three times, you don't want to do that because that would then make this three-dimensional and quite messy. Okay? So if you have more than two events, then you want to consider going back to the tree diagram that we had at the beginning. All right? So let's go ahead and do maybe one more. Okay? Let's say, what is the probability that the difference between the dice is 1? Okay, so die 1 minus die 2 is 1, or die 2 minus die 1 is 1. Well, I know that right here down the middle, that's where they're the same, right? 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. So it should be right next to that. Okay, so 2 minus 1, right there, I'm using a black marker this time. 3 minus 2, 4 minus 3. Again, you see a pattern, right? The patterns help us. If you see things all over the place, then you're probably making some kind of mistake, but there should be some kind of nice pattern. Now remember, we gotta do the other side too, because it just says the difference is 1. So, let's see, 2 minus 1 right here, 3 minus 2, 4 minus 3, and again that pattern all the way down to 6 minus 5, and you'll note that we have a total of 10 out of 36, or 5 out of 18. All right, so hopefully that gets you started. Let me just show you one more. I did mention, okay, well, what if I had a coin and a die? Just so you see one that's a little bit different. So you do your die on the side. Okay, the die would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then your coin would go right here, which would be heads or tails. Again, you draw a line for each one. There's your heads, tails, and there's your one. You can make them as long as you want. It doesn't have to be a nice, even square grid like this. In fact, this one won't be a square. But again, your sample space, the different possible outcomes, are the things where they intersect, right? So you can get a one and a heads. You can get a one and a tails. You can get a two and a heads. You can get a two and a tails. You can get a three and a heads. You can get a three and a tails, all right? So that's basically what how you can set up an easy sample space. This is an easy way of listing the possibilities. This also works instead of writing down your whole sample space, instead of going, well, one in heads, heads in two, heads in three. You don't have to write out everything if you have a sample space that fits the situation. All right? Anyway, hopefully that's helpful. Try to get started on the homework, work together. The sub hopefully will be able to help you out, and I'll see you next time.